presentation on linear algebra applications in computer science. My name is Carlos Manrique. So, application one, getting a lower image resolution. So, imagine that you're given a high resolution image and we need to a lower resolution version of it so that our website can load it quickly. So as we can see, this image has a lower resolution. It's not just the size, I mean, it should be adjusted, but the resolution is lower than the big one. And how can we accomplish this? So we're gonna look to downsample the image. We're gonna look for the some rectangles. We're gonna divide the first picture in rectangles. That's gonna be the high resolution one. And these little rectangles represent the pixels. And as we know, a higher quality picture has more pixels, so these rows of rectangles, the small ones that are dotted, those are going to be the high resolution ones. When we come to the whole picture and we see the big rectangle, those are going to represent the pixels of that lower resolution picture image. So that's how we're going to see our pictures. And mathematically, we're going to make use of vectors and matrices. So let's see, each pixel of the lower resolution image corresponds to a little grid of pixels of the higher resolution image represented as dotted triangles. This is pretty much what I just mentioned. Let's represent the higher resolution image as a vector u. So let's keep in mind that u is going to be the higher resolution image. We're going to compute the lower resolution image, and this requires a one dot product for each pixel of that image. So if we want to change, we have to change every single picture, pixel. Sorry. So we're going to construct the matrix M, whose rows are the vectors that must be dotted with U. We're going to see what M is about. B is going to be the vector representing the low resolution image, our result of that dot product of the high quality picture. By the M matrix that we're going to see now. So we're going to suppose that our high resolution image has dimensions 3000 by 2000. And our goal is to create a low resolution image with dimensions of 750 by 500. And as computer scientists and computer science students know, and programmers, is that we start our vectors from zero to the number that we want to get to. So if we want 3000, we're going to start from 0 to 2999 by another vector of 0 to 1999, which would represent the 2000. Now for the B, it would start from the domain would be from 0 to 749 by 0 to 499. And as we can recall, our B is the vector representing the lower image, the lower resolution image, which is going to be our result, and the U is going to be the high resolution image that we're going to multiply with that vector M, as we can see in the equation. So this is where the solution comes. So the corresponding row M is the vector that is all zeros except for the 4x4 grid of high resolution pixel coordinates. So what we're saying right here is that we're gonna have a vector. We're gonna have M that is gonna have multiple zeros, but at some points it's gonna have some numbers, which are gonna be, you know, the 4x4 grid. That way we have 4i, 4j, 4i, 4j plus 1. And that way they're gonna be multiples of 4, and we're gonna grab just some of the pixels of the high resolution image, and not all of them, because M is a vector that contains all zeros except for the 4x4 grid. And that way, by making the dot product of M by U, which is the high resolution image, we're gonna get our lower resolution image. And this is pretty useful because there are companies that already use it, like Facebook, and YouTube also, Twitter, and yeah, this is how it's done. So we're gonna go to the next application. It's more like an explanation of how this works. This just has a little bit of math, but let's check it out. So consider the problem of streaming a video through a network. Here's a simple example of a network. So S would represent the video that we are streaming, and C and D would be the customers, the people who are gonna watch our stream video. Now these channels are gonna be they are just paths in which our video is gonna go to our customers. So then at the top, as I previously mentioned, S needs to stream a video to each of the two customers' nodes, labeled C and D. Let's recall the image. C and D are our customers, and S is the video. Located at the bottom, each link in the network has a capacity of 1 megabit per second. Each link in the network has a capacity of 1 megabit per second, and those are the channels for the paths. The video stream, however, requires 2 megabits per second if there were only 2 megabits per second. If there were only one customer, this would be no problem, as shown below. And this is what we have. But this would be ideal if we only had only one customer, as I mentioned. So our solution is here. At the centermost node, the bits B1 and B2 arrive and are combined to Golius field 2, in which B1 and B2, which are the two channels and megabits, are going to be combined and shared to C and D. We're going to use the Golius field 2 addition to obtain a single bit, and this single bit is transmitted as shown to the two customers, C and D. Customer C receives B1. Which is actually not necessarily now, because since we are sharing both here, and the sum B1 plus 2. With this, we have shown that the network that appears to support streaming only 1 megabit per second to a pair of customers actually supports streaming 2 megabits per second. This is obviously, this can be used also for a bigger network.